rocking your Saturdays with people like Dr. Leroy Talis, the Black Starlet.
I just feel it, the party.
Gypsy.
Feeling in a brass band or jump into a steel pan.
The Mighty Sparrow. Kitchener.
We use the walk lovers lane every blessed Saturday night.
You just name it, we got it. Right here on Heritage Radio 101.7 FM with the big man in the business, Harold Piro. Don't forget, it's real culture. Every Saturday from 2 to 5 p.m. right here on Heritage Radio 101.7 FM.
Okay, listeners, welcome back to today's edition of the Sports Drive. Joining me now live on the show is a very distinguished guest. He's been the darling of Trinidad and Tobago football for so many years. He continues to fly the red, white, and black. He's done so much for Trinidad and Tobago football over the years, both as a player and a coach. This is none other than Russell Latapy, the little magician, who is now doing a tremendous job out in Scotland as the assistant coach for Inverness Caledonian Thistle. Russell, you're on the line. Welcome to today's Sports Drive program.
Yeah, Sean, how are you doing? Thanks for having me.
Very well, very well. Obviously, we continue to follow the exploits of yourself. And, back in your playing days, remember you were the clubs such as Hibernian, Glasgow Rangers, and Falkirk, but now in a different capacity. As the assistant coach for Inverness, you guys are continuing to play some wonderful football and pressing for a spot in Europe, maintaining your place in the top three in the Scottish Premiership. Tell us about, your recent exploits and how the season has gone so far.
It's been a wonderful season so far. We're punching well above our weight here. Our philosophy is to get the ball down and try to maintain possession and create goal scoring opportunities. And we've been fortunate this season and that we were able to do that. And the players have taken all our coaching on board, and it shows. The table shows, we're creating chances, we're defending well, we're scoring goals, and we're putting points on the board. So we're delighted about that, but there is still a long way to go. It's a funny league in that you play each other quite a few times during the season, and both teams get to know each other so very well during this type of format. But again, we're delighted with the way things are going, and hopefully we can continue.
Very well. Saying that, you are now, just the other day people could remember you putting on the red, white, and black, running out for the national team. In your capacity now, how do you cope with the fact that you're unable to really go out there and put the ball down on the pitch and do as you would like? How have you been able to settle in now as a coach as opposed to your years before, even right there in Scotland as a player? I'm sure there is that eagerness inside of you to still want to play at some point in time.
I think one of the funny things about football is that the knowledge you gain once you're much older and your understanding of the game is a lot greater than when you played. So when you played, you have the legs and the stamina to run about and do things, and things happen for you. But to make things actually happen and have an understanding how to pull teams about and how to create opportunities and create space, you get that understanding when you're much older. So it is funny in that the more you understand the game, is the less capacity that you have physically to do it, But it's been an interesting adjustment, because just with the knowledge that you've gained over the years, and trying to pass it on to some of these younger players, and they taking it on board, it's a great satisfaction.
So glad to hear that, Russell. In terms of your experience out there now, when you were a player, Trinidad and Tobago in particular had several players in the UK leagues and other parts of Europe. We've seen that number decreased over the years. Do you still think that there is something of a market for players from the Caribbean and Trinidad and Tobago in Scotland, in England? Remember the days of Marvin Andrews and Anthony Rozier and these guys being there in Scotland, and you don't seem to have those numbers anymore. What is your take on this?
No, there is definitely a market here. We've always had talented players in the Caribbean, and that hasn't changed. I suppose it's just the right opportunities. You know, me being out here, I'm hoping that I can kind of create some of these opportunities for some of the younger kids at home, you know. So I suppose it's just a question of time before some of these doors can be open. But in answering that question, yes, we have talent, and there is a market for these players in not only Scotland but in Europe.
Of course, it seems very much that your heart still is very close with Trinidad and Tobago.
In football, just like in life, in most relationships, you know, whatever kind of relationship it might be, there is always ups and downs, you know. But I personally feel very disappointed in the way that things panned out with the Federation, you know. Obviously, there's case going on against the Federation because I didn't get paid when I was there from the last administration. In saying that, I must say fair play to the present administration because they accepted the responsibility for the last administration. You know, but like I said before, I'm disappointed because I try to keep everything out of public. And I try to resolve the situation as amicable as possible. But nothing seems to be happening. You know, a year ago, in January 2014, you know, I sat down with the present administration and decided that we wouldn't take this thing to court and don't go any further with a contract, a written contract from them stating that the situation would be resolved in December 2014. So I've been forced to go back to court with this situation against the Federation. The present situation right now is I was forced to take legal matters again, and then it's all in the court's hands, and then we'll see what happens from there. And I feel as though I gave them the opportunity a year ago to try and resolve the situation. It hasn't happened, and I'm back in the same place that I was a year ago with taking it to court again, you know, and I'm really, really hurt and disappointed about this situation, you know, especially seeing, you know, the role that I played for the last 30 years for Trinidad football.
It's really disappointing to hear that, Russell, and I want to assure you that there are a lot of people in Trinidad and Tobago, and even in the football fraternity, that feel the same way. It's just really unfortunate, and what I can say to you is that you know, you're not the only person in this situation right now. I know sometimes you may feel as though it's just a personal thing, and it's just yourself, but there's so many other people that, you know, the TTFA continues to face this challenge with, and one can only hope that under the leadership of the current president, Raymond Timke, who has had it really up to his throat in recent times for the past year or more, that there is some form of resolution at some stage, because we all know that you deserve to get what you duly owed because of your contribution to football.
What I would say to you though, Sean, is that in football, I've realized that you don't take anything personal, you know. But in saying that, I would say that in present situations like this, you know, we normally look after the foreign people. It was a foreign coach or whatever, the situation would have been resolved. But again, one of the things that I'm disappointed in, Sean, right? Like I said to you a while ago, this situation has been ongoing for 4 or 5 years.
And you've been patient.
The Super Warriors.
Yeah.
And I gave them the opportunity and we sat down and we tried to resolve it. And I gave them the opportunity by saying, okay, let's work this thing out. You know, I didn't go to court at the time. Now, we're talking about pretty much 14 months after, I'm back to the same situation without them really being courteous and saying, listen, we're working on this thing, let's do something about it. And we got to a point that they're saying to me, listen, we don't have any money. And I'm saying, well, okay, what am I supposed to do? Am I supposed to just sit down here 5 years after I was supposed to get paid and not do anything? So, unfortunately, the reality of this situation is that I have to go back and take legal advice, and now the situation is back in court, and then the courts will decide exactly what's going to happen with the situation.
Rather unfortunate, Russell, and I'm pretty sure that the powers that be will be hearing your reaction, and they must know that, you know, this matter has gotten to a stage that it really shouldn't have reached. What I can tell you from my capacity somebody who is involved with the TTF is that we're going to take this back to them and obviously see how best forward, to resolve this matter. We all know what you've done for football in Trinidad and Tobago and the contributions you still continue to make. In saying that, we're going to stay in touch. But what I would like to also say to you is that, you know, football in the country is progressing, but very slowly. One of your former teammates and a good friend of yours, in Stone John, is something that I'm involved with him right now, where we're going to launch an academy here in Trinidad. It's called the Football Sevens Academy, where kids are going to be the focus. We know that you have a liking as well for development at the youth stage. You've helped kids develop in Scotland and wherever you've played before. What do you feel about somebody like Stone getting involved in this initiative, and what would you have to say to him, to in some way try to take Trinidad and Tobago football forward?
No, absolutely. You know, Stone was a top player in his time, and he's contributed vastly to the well-being of Trinidad football. I think it's a good project. I think that players, ex-players, and people who've contributed like Stone needs to get involved and try to bring the football again to the level that I think that we should be at. Again, what I would say to you is that I've been involved for Trinidad football for the past 3 decades. Whatever advice he needs on anything, I'm just a phone call away. As you know, Sean, I've done my UEFA Pro badges here in Scotland. I was successful in it, so I've got the top badges in terms of football. And again, whatever advice Stu needs, or whatever advice anybody needs in the development of football, the federation, whatever, I'm only a phone call away, and I'll do my best. And again, I'll take this opportunity to say good luck to Stu, and I'm really proud of him and this project he's trying to go forward with.
That's a really good note for us to end on, Russell. What I can tell you as well is that we're going to obviously continue discussions. I'm going to ensure that those at the TTFA hear what your reactions have been. We want to thank you so much for joining us on today's edition of the Sports Drive, and we wish you the very best for the rest of the season in Scotland. Thank you so much, Russell.
I appreciate that, Sean. Thanks for having me.
Okay. So, listeners, we've come to the end of another edition of the Sports Drive program. I'm Sean Fuentes, your host for today's program, and we're going to head into the news at the top of the hour.